All right, so continuing our tour of warm season grasses, here we have sorghum bicolor, which is grain sorghum. So we're going to walk through a few different types of sorghum. This first one here has been selected for grain. So you'll see it's quite short in stature. So it is almost interchangeable in its uses with our field corn. So grain sorghum can be used to feed livestock. It can be used to make ethanol. It can be used for sweeteners. So corn, we also, the field corn we use for high fructose corn syrup. We can also use sorghum for syrups and sweeteners. So you'll see on this one here, some of these are just pollinating now. So they're in flower. Unlike corn, they have their complete flowers on all together on the same plant. So male and female parts are together. And then they form these dense clusters of round seed heads. So this plant here has been selected preferentially for grain. So it's relatively short in stature, doesn't have a lot of leaf material, and most of its energy and reserves go into the grain. It is alternative. It is grown in warmer climates often than some of our corn, and it is very drought tolerant. So it's very water efficient relative to our corn. So as water becomes more limited and as climate gets warmer, we're seeing more and more producers switch actually from field corn to sorghum in some environments, especially southern Kansas, Oklahoma, Texas in areas. Next we have our forage sorghum. It is the exact same genus and species. So this is also sorghum bicolor. Notice the very different size. These have been selected for very different uses from the exact same baseline genetic material. So our forage sorghum is used for forage. Forage is something that we chop in its green material, green form, vegetative state like this, and feed to livestock. Often it'll get packed in these bunkers you'll often see around larger dairy and beef farms. And fermented slightly to improve the digestibility of that forage for our livestock. So it is not going to form dense seed heads on the top. So it is selected primarily for tall growth and vegetation and biomass production. Moving on from that, we have another forage type. This forage type here is sudangrass. Notice it has much narrower leaf blades than our forage sorghum. Similar height or slightly taller, very loose open, what we call panicle or seed head. These are all grasses in the Poaceae family. And this one has a very open grass seed head, very typical of many of our wild type grasses. All of these are native to East Africa or Sub-Saharan Africa region. Sudangrass is a higher biomass producing even than our forage sorghum. And if we look down towards the bottom, we'll see the very large number of stems. These are called tillers. And so one seed will produce all of these stems. So that increases the biomass production of this species. It is also exceptionally drought tolerant and adapted to warm climates. So we took the best of both worlds, that sudangrass here, which is also sorghum bicolor, but it's a variety Sudanese, and crossed it with our forage sorghum to get this one in the middle here. This is our sorghum sudangrass hybrid, and it is crossing both the sudangrass and the forage sorghum. We've gotten the best of both worlds. It's higher biomass producing. We have a few more tillers or stalks per seed, and very highly productive, very high biomass producing plants. So that's, again, all the same genus and species that we've selected for very different traits.